Say, mister, are you one of them badass rock stars?
Oh, Jen, you scared the crap out of me.
Sorry, babe. Hey, Lewis, what's up?
This huge freak in the crowd kept staring at me like some whacked out psycho.
Well, maybe you never checked out your audience before, but you guys don't exactly share the same fan base as Kenny G.
Oh, this was different. He looks seriously creepy.
Ooh, that reminds me. Grab your money and let's split. We gotta go visit the landlord.
Great set, man!
Come on. If we don't pay him tonight, we're gonna be living in a box.
Ah, Jen. You never used to complain. I think we're growing apart.
I'm 21 now, Lewis. Too old to be living like a bum. Plus, I'm gonna need study space once I start college. No autographs, creep.
Good night, guys. See you next time.
See you, buddy.
God, what is that thing?
Hey! Don't make me hurt you.
Man.
Is this your Jane Doe?
Yeah. Came in 2 nights ago. Hasn't come round yet. She's a fighter, though. I've lost plenty with injuries less than hers.
5 broken ribs, lung punctured in 2 places, ruptured spleen. What'd you do, get hit by a truck?
Yeah, she left some nightclub with her boyfriend. That looks like a gang jumped them. Left her lying outside the club. They found him several blocks away. He's in the room 3 doors down.
So, what do you think?
50-50.
Come on, Doctor. There's a coffee and donut downstairs. Need your attention.
That was one freaky dream. This, hospital? What the hell happened? Oh my God. I'm dead? No, I don't want to be dead. Things were just starting to work out. Louis and I were just... Oh my God. Louis. What happened to us? Huh? What the hell are you? A bit short for the Grim Reaper, aren't ya?
You're not dead, Jennifer. But if you don't be quiet and listen to me, you soon will be. My name is... Well, let's say you can call me Scree. I've been sent to find you, to show you some very important things, and to enlist your assistance.
Right. Well, Scree... Glad I'm not dead. But first you better explain how come I'm looking down on myself. She is creeping me out.
Your corporeal form, the one still lying there, is very weak, close to death perhaps, but not yet lost. That is only part of you. The other part, your spirit. That's you. I set it free from your body so that we could talk. In fact, now that it's free, you'll find you can travel to places you've never even imagined.
Right, so I'm like an astral projection or something?
Essentially, yes.
So what does that make you?
I am but a humble servant to my lady, and to you I'm a friend, someone you need to trust. Now quickly, you must come with me. We're both vulnerable here.
Okay, but only 'cause I'm intrigued. I've never been in astral projection before.
Okay, Jennifer.
What the hell? My God. What just happened? Where are we?
Questions. We're no longer immortalis. We've stepped through a rift gate into the Nexus.
Still, huh?
As I said earlier, your spirit is no longer constrained by flesh. You have left the physical mortal world and now stand in the Nexus, a convergence point for energies drawn from the 4 realms of Oblivion.
Sounds like one of Lewis's fantasy novels.
This is real, Jennifer. I know you mortals think you're at the heart of everything, but believe me, you're not. Now please try to absorb all of this quickly. There really is no time to waste.
Okay, I'm trying. Just one thing, though. No matter where we are, you gotta stop calling me Jennifer. You sound like my stepdad. It's Jen.
I am to give you these. They are devices that will help you to learn of your true self. And if my lady is correct, they may afford us some protection.
What am I supposed to do with this?
It's a vamp brace. They fasten around your wrists. Please, it's important that you trust me and just put them on.
I've just jumped out of my skin, left my body in some hospital, been dragged through a rift gate.
Rift gate?
And I'm in oblivion. Vambrace? Not a problem.
Precisely.
Ooh, shiny. And pretty comfy for a pair of metal doodads. Could have been made for me.
They were.
So, how do I get them off?
You don't.
And this guy wants me to trust him. This lady you keep mentioning, who is she?
I serve Arella. She is all that is good and pure. She is strength and virtue. She is righteousness. She is nobility.
She's a person, right?
She is not a person. She is not mere flesh and bone, emotion and desire. She is one of two primal forces that govern the universe. She is order.
And the other would be...
The other would be Abaddon, the embodiment of chaos, lord of corruption and decay. He is my lady's eternal foe and the reason for my being.
Right. You know you're gonna have to introduce me to this Arella.
Oh, I shall, and she will be most relieved to see you. But first, I must show you more of Oblivion. Please follow me.
Scree, will all this start making sense anytime soon? Is there nothing you can say that won't leave my head spinning?
I think that perhaps your Lewis may have been brought here.
Lewis? Lewis here? You've got to help me find him.
Come on, this way!
So, they got one of these.
With the might of chaos and order eternally battling, a balance between them must also be fought for. Here at the heart of the Nexus is where that happens. Drawing in the two primal forces, governing, generating a safe parallel energy, that is the awesome responsibility of Kronos.
And awesome's the word for this gadget. Someone in the middle of all that.
As I said, Jen, Kronos.
Jeez, he's looking at me.
Perhaps he can hear you, too.
Well... I'm sure the guy's doing a great job in there. On there. Oh my god, Scree, he's plugged into the damn thing.
It is an ancient machine, with Kronos living at its heart. There are four realms in Oblivion, Jen. Two aligned with order and two with chaos. Each realm has its own natural balance, eternally generating the right levels of primal energy, which is drawn into the Nexus and fed through Kronos to Arella and Abaddon. Kronos has eternally governed with wisdom and impartiality, channeling balanced strength to them both. Without him, the Nexus, Oblivion, and your Mortalis wouldn't exist at all. Simple as that.
You know, if I was as wise as this Kronos, I'd find a cushier job. Pull out the jacks and swing in the hammock for a while.
For all our sakes, I trust your own sense of responsibility matches your distinctive sense of humor.
Distinctive good or distinctive?
Distinctive inappropriate.
Jeez, I'm being heckled by a troll. Is he okay? That doesn't look too healthy.
No. The force of chaos is overpowering him. Abaddon is putting his ancient plan into practice, a break with eternity. He's secretly corrupting the kingdoms of order, strengthening the realms of chaos, foolishly rocking the Nexus like a boat about to capsize. Just look at our guardian suffering to keep control. He may not last very long. Come on, Jen, we have no time to lose.
Okay, I'm coming. Just don't leave me behind here. It's no good. I'm gonna have to ask Scree.
Questions again. And if there's something I'd want you to ask, you never do. What, please?
These symbols.
Ah.
I presume you have noticed this.
Indeed, there is a remarkable similarity.
They are identical, you lunk. Louis drew the design for me just after we met. How come the symbol's all over the place here?
I simply can't tell you.
Can't or won't?
It's branded on you, Jen, not me. I don't know everything.
It's not branded, it's just a tattoo, goddammit. Louis told me it was an ancient rune of protection. I just thought it looked cool.
Where did Louis see this symbol? It's very important.
He wouldn't tell me. Oh, forget it. Everything else going on, that ain't gonna freak me out. Come on, little guy.
We have entered the kingdom of Solum. Time stands still in the four realms connected to the Nexus. In this realm, it is eternal night.
And let me guess. Eternal winter?
By nature, Solum is bleak of climate, but nothing too harsh for its people. The Ferae are strong and resourceful hunters.
You say hunters?
The worlds of Oblivion are each inhabited by a different race, and yes, the Ferae are fierce, sometimes brutal, but they are fundamentally good. You're going to meet a lot worse, I assure you.
Splendid.
Solum and its people have always been aligned with order, providing my Lady Arella with power.
But now things have gotten screwed up, right?
Yes, thanks to Abaddon's villainy. His interference in the realms is drawing all the primal energy to his side and starving my lady of her very existence. In truth, neither side can survive without the other, and soon everything will be destroyed.
So the guy's trashing the status quo, creating chaos. Guess he's doing his job.
And we must do ours, so just listen.
Oops.
I'm sorry. You must forgive me for that, Jen. So much more will become clear to you, child, but we've so little time.
Hey, look, don't sweat it. I'm fine. So what's to be done here? Let's get on with it.
Thank you, Jen. Right, now, what we've got to do here, Jen, is... I haven't the faintest idea. But I do know Solum has been tainted by chaos somehow, and we have to restore the natural order. I told you the Ferae are violent, but they live as a basically peaceful clan with rituals and art, for example, a structured society. The one crucial thing for the race is their king. In Solum, the king has huge authority, awesome strength, but he must, without fail, sacrifice himself at the height of his power and pass the throne to his heir.
Gruesome.
Ah, yes, the burning crown, the traditional method of royal sacrifice. failure of the king to abdicate his power would devastate the land and lead its people to ruin.
Ruin as in?
Precisely. The king here is Hearn, strong, deadly even, but always a good leader for his people, I believe. A Ferai king like any other through eternity. But some time ago, he was due to relinquish power.
And he's running for another term.
He is senselessly refusing to give up his rule, and so leading the Ferai to disaster.
So we check it out. Cool.
Yes. A sound plan of action. I'll quite happily lead the way whenever you like.
That did not sound too friendly. Let's find another way around. You hear those growls, Scree?
That sounds like Malkai. They're primitive, territorial beasts. Huge teeth, fearsome claws, fond of the dark.
Well, that's it. We ain't moving. Oh, no.
I suspect they'd only be interested in devouring you.
Oh, great.
I doubt they'd find me too palatable.
Sure. You don't look particularly tasty.
Malkai are afraid of fire. I'll scout ahead, see if I can find anything.
I'll stay here until you get back.
This should keep those Malkai at bay. Mangy curves! I've illuminated the cave, Jen. It should be safe for you to enter.
Small point. Typical picky me. Should be safe or is safe?
It is safe.
Well done, big guy.
If you need information, just ask me and I'll do my best to help. You can look at my maps whenever you like. They're updated as we progress. You know, being small and made from stone has some advantages.
It does?
Absolutely. I can climb up any stonework surface. Now that's something that might be useful to us, don't you think?
I guess.
Help me out, would you? That wind.
Uh-oh.
Don't panic. They can smell fear, you know.
You're not on the menu here. I'll smell how I want.
It's Hearn. Don't worry. I can speak the demon tongue. Deus Safinta, Dwend em Gen, Eb em Ota Jimen Diarella, Eb Hiven Keferai, Ecta Sansetem Rekba.
This runt would have me believe you're an envoy of the goddess Arella. You look more like a sniveling half-breed to me.
Scree, I vote we're big enough to swallow the odd insult here.
Strangers, in these treacherous times, should I drive you from my kingdom or leave you to the Maokai?
Trust me, Lord Hearn, we're here to help you.
Help me? I suppose you must know the whereabouts of my son, then.
Well, no.
Then you are of no use. It was a night like this when Jared went missing.
But listen, I do know what it's like to lose someone. My friend Lewis was taken from me. Couldn't we at least help you look for Jared?
You seem ill-equipped to be helping anyone. Take this, and you may just survive the night.
Thanks.
I have no more time for strangers. I must return to the Great Temple. Perhaps tonight my prayers will be answered.
I guess we know what he prays for.
The safe return of his son.
Come on, Scree. We can do it. Let's find this Jared.
Fine, fine, as you wish. I'll add him to the list.
Hey, why do you call me a half-breed?
Perhaps it's time for me to scout ahead again.
What you doing?
It's called a lodestone. They're important. You'll find out later.
You are one strange critter, Scree.
I need to find a way to get Jen over here. That tree seems ready to fall at any moment. Should do the job as a makeshift bridge. Thank you.
so many earthquakes.
The land suffers as a result of Hearn's poor judgment. Several moons have passed since he failed to relinquish his throne.
He didn't fail, Scree. How can he let go when there's no heir to take over?
Of course. Of course! Finding Jared could be the key to restoring the balance in Solum. Good job, Jed. We should ask these tribesmen if they know anything about Jared's disappearance.
Shoot.
Beagni, neti vasus agap di kip gaxi kod volvek Jared?
Ip anot bot kap ki. Ob non gyanol rule yedon vumin la bap ot vern klumpad. Ob sa kernast Jared nukti.
Apparently Jared used to hunt here. Some time ago, the locals heard a terrible fight raging. Nobody's seen him since.
Looks like we've hit a dead end.
This isn't a good sign.
What is it?
It's a piece of a ferrite horn. It has an engraved tip. The symbol is similar to one used by Hearn's family.
I guess we should show it to him then. just stand there watching. Help me out here.
I think we'll need to split up here. I can climb down. I'm afraid you'll have to find another way.
Down, someone's coming.
What's going on here?
Who's she?
Ah, it's Lady Divina.
Wait, Scree. I don't know who she is, but this does not look like a welcoming committee.
Casusdis is includi vit deos jaluenari.
Di job tu penny, barduli alheg diden, dur san jib mob vedum bolhen, deos nid jub bub caverbe.
Tupid! Du lasu san pen, ati san apa.
No.
I don't understand. Divina is known as a noble and just queen. Why would she have someone murdered like that?
Guess she ain't the gal she used to be.
The prisoner was no criminal. He was a shaman, a Ferai holy man. He spoke of uncovering Divina's secret and that there were others still loyal to Hearn. We must find out what he meant.
Wonder if Hearn knows about his wife's mean streak.
I doubt it, and I don't relish the task of telling him.
I sure can jump. Scree, what's with the glowing stuff?
Happens when I'm close to stone figures resonating with ferrite energy. It means I can temporarily transfer my soul into any statue formed from this material.
Cool.
Cool? Just wait till you see me do it. Then you'll see what I'm made of. Cool.
Okay. Go ahead. That's a fine statue. A lovely glow.
I can't do it yet. I need the essence from more ferrite lodestones before I can shift form.
Okay, calm down. I'll take your word for it. Rocky.
If only she knew.
Abinag, sanbinan huvnilak, trasus eni inonak, abinagdi, trasus eni inonak, abinagdi, trasus eni inonak, abinagdi, abinag, sanbinan huvnilak, trasus eni inonak, abinagdi. Trasus any inonak, apinagdi. Trasus any inonak, apinagdi. Apinag, sanbinan huvnilak. Trasus any inonak, apinagdi. Trasus any inonak, apinagdi.
Found this.
Apinagdi. Quips and Binan! You! Why do you interrupt my ritual? What is this? What have you found? This is Jared's. Where did you find it?
It was lying in an old ruin. There was blood and signs of a battle, and corpses.
My son?
No. Three huntsmen had fallen in combat. this was the only sign of Jared.
I must discover my son's fate. And find those who have wronged him.
Lord Hearn, how is Lady Divina coping with your son's disappearance?
My wife keeps her own counsel these days.
Well, the last time we saw her... What the...
Have the gods answered my pleas, or do they mock me?
Scree, what just happened? What's he talking about?
Show me your arms, half-breed.
Half-breed, there he goes again.
Can you truly be Arella's champion?
Get your paws off me, Scree!
It is true. You don't yet hold the power, but I believe that you are Arella's chosen.
I haven't prepared her for this yet.
Then I suggest you do so quickly!
Scree? What's happening? These damn vambrace are burning me!
Be calm. They're merely channeling powers that exist within you. You are part demon, Jen. You were brought into oblivion as a baby, your soul tainted by the touch of chaos. Hearn has awakened the ferri within you. The vambrace are merely catalysts for change.
Scree, it hurts!
Your body will be able to adopt each of the demon aspects of oblivion. The first time a form is awakened, the transition may be painful, but trust me, you will adjust.
What have you done to me?
Stay calm. You are in control of this. You may change form when you desire. There's nothing to be afraid of. Your humanity is not lost. However, you will find that the ferri aspect has many advantages. Agility, strength, stamina, and if I dare say it, you're far more pleasing on the eye. Sadly, as you may have noted with Hearn, the ferri aren't renowned for their good nature. My point precisely.
I bet I can jump up there easy. Bouncy!
Certain stones in Oblivion are highly charged with the essence of the land. By crushing them, I am able to harvest this energy. I believe it will be of use to us. Or more specifically, to you.
How so?
I'm able to absorb the energy that you will need to maintain strength in your demon forms. I can also drain this energy from the corpses of your foes.
A bit morbid.
Yes, well, I'm sure you'll come to thank me for it. You know you can summon demon energy from me whenever you need it, okay?
emgasus hoc eog joana binanshedi vode od bolvof chabakumid, penda vitvan sephup shakri pedele vibane koyos kak, ot naka, pijade eos piab giliem velimid vapapota nogin. Vonod lirog bol eos honey. Lin really eos vapor galcitos, lin really eos trapolin, lin really eos binan bolsidi, lin really eos vapor galcitos, lin really eos trapolin, lin really eos binan bolsidi. Two are come.
Sorry to interrupt you there.
Velboft eoso trilacrun.
No further!
Do they know? They approach the sacred grounds. Doubtless you are right.
We saw your fire, that's all.
We're kinda asking everyone. Have you seen Prince Jared? We're trying to find him.
Spin it! A spirit walking with... Well, why don't you ask him?
I guess you haven't seen him then, huh?
Nobody approaches the sacred necropolis. Even princes, be warned. Keep away.
We must travel no further. The necropolis is sacred to the Ferae.
Scree. Duh! Jared's vanished. Of course he'd never be seen in a place where nobody ever goes. We've got to check it out.
Balrapin bik visvat.
Balrapin, trali nawa viak hurgod.
Scree, tell him it's okay. We've just eaten.
But we haven't.
Just say I'm a vegetarian, then.
Enojeskakun, I don't think they have a word for that, Jen.
Hey! What's with Fido?
Duende mot venar per di ramul herg verman sort.
What'd he say?
He was, complimenting you on your odor.
You mean my perfume?
Yes, that's it.
Well, it's been fun, guys, but... Come on, Scree, let's bail. I'll need Scree to help me with this.
Thank you.
I'll need Scree to help me with this. I'll need Scree to help me with this. Looks like there's something missing from the lock. Yeah, okay, that was quite impressive. A rock of many talents. Listen up. I'm sorry, but there's something you need to know.
She will speak.
That sacred place of yours isn't quite so off-limits as you think. It's crawling with people.
Jen, allow me to handle this. Sir, the necropolis, we have evidence of Ferai presence there. Guards, archers.
It's what I said.
You have dared to set your dirty feet there.
My companion here lost her bearings and...
The point is, they are there. You know about that? What are they doing?
It is a sacrilege!
I'd say they're there for a purpose. They're using the cover of sacred land, guarded by yourself here, warning people off as a hideaway. And the one who is hidden is Jared.
Stop!
Now, continue.
Sir, the only path to sanctity, the kingdom's survival, is for Jared to be found. And then Hearn will be able to relinquish his throne. We need to explore the necropolis.
No one passes this.
We're asking your blessing.
Meanwhile, there are soldiers stamping all over that hallowed place.
Stamping with their dirty feet.
Yes, and we're willing to get them out of there.
No more. You have my blessing. In these accursed days, we look beyond our first desires.
Why? For the spirit.
If you are to enter the necropolis, you will need this.
Stand there, watch and help me out here.
Oh.
Scree, could you give me some help here? Hey there.
Contact. We see any door is sitting.
Jared, is that you?
What have they done to him?
Your father has been wild with despair.
My father.
Take it easy. Come on, let me get these chains off you.
What happened to you?
On a hunt some moons ago, I was attacked by that fiend who sits at my father's right hand.
Who do you mean?
Captured. Tortured. Chained here ever since. Forced to listen as she came back and told me of each new act of wickedness she'd inflicted on my people. Each trick she played to inflame my father's misery.
What? Wait up. Divina did this to you? Your own mother?
No! Not my mother! That thing that calls itself Divina, that lies down with my father set on choking out my bloodline, bringing this realm to its knees. That thing is an imposter. A shape-shifter, not born of this land.
How can you be so sure when even your father, the king, suspects nothing?
She couldn't resist telling me. Smiled and said my mother lay in a chamber nearby. This imposter often goes there. I've heard chanting. Terrible noises.
Well, let's go and see if we can get in there then.
She's no fool. It'll be locked.
Ah, fine. I was only...
And the key, Highness?
If it's anywhere, the key may be in her rooms at my father's fortress. Yes, She suddenly took to keeping her rooms heavily guarded just before I was abducted. Now if we... You must help me. This imposter must be revealed. If I only had strength, we have to...
Save your strength, Highness. It is best that no one knows that we have discovered you here. Rest now while we find this key.
Yeah, and make him think I haven't untied you.
My friend, I am truly grateful for your help. I can sense your strength, even if you do not have a look of a warrior.
You wouldn't say that if you'd seen her earlier.
Okay then, Scree. Let's head for the fortress.
Please, take this talisman. It will prove your worth to my countrymen.
We will return.
Looks like you found an admirer.
Button it, Scree. We got a fortress to raid. We better move it, fella. It's a long way back to the city.
Then I suggest we take the easy way, Jen. The Rift Gate.
I don't want you arriving there exhausted.
Me?
Rift Gates outside of the Nexus are a little different to those within. Before we can use this one, we must first power up the outer disks. You take one wheel, I'll take the other. We need to build up sufficient speed so that a passageway may be formed.
Okay.
I'm sure you'd be capable of that jump we saw those Ferrae make.
Thank you.
We'll show him the talisman Jared gave us.
Gili inopiab, ubgasa duen.
Hit you a piab.
Dukaskon.
Scree, could you give me some help here?
Let me get that.
Wow.
It is rather grand, isn't it? The old kings would stage hunts here for the public, rituals as cruel as they were spectacular. Divina had always been opposed to the practice, and it was no surprise when it was outlawed after Hearn became High King.
Ooh, spooky. That statue reminds me of you somehow.
Ah, well, that's Abdizur. It's interesting that you mention it because...
Except he looks like a fearsome, impressive creature, and you, well, I mean, well, you're you.
Yes, well, as you say.
You should not have come here.
Abaddon.
The runes are cast. Abdizur is lost. Why fight me, daughter?
You! What have you done with Lewis?
Run! You've seen Belazur's strength! Quickly, then, hide!
Nice work, Scree.
Now that took me back.
That was the thing that jumped me and Lewis at the club. What was it?
That's Belazur, a demon of chaos, Abaddon's most lethal killer. Where he travels, pain and suffering will surely follow.
You seem to handle him quite well.
The mighty form of Abdizur was thankfully at hand. Abdizur and Belazur have fought many titanic battles.
Yeah? Well, you and the big man made a great team. Don't you think so, Rocky boy?
Belazur is far from destroyed. I merely bought us some time.
The face in the smoke... It was talking to me, wasn't it?
You saw a shade of Abaddon.
He called me daughter.
A And then he sent a monster to kill you. Abaddon is chaos, Jen. Don't let him wreak havoc in your mind.
I want Louis Scree. I need Louis to be here.
Right. We are both thinking too much, and both feeling sorry for ourselves. All we need to think about, my girl, is a way out of this arena.
This thing weighs a ton. I might need your help here.
Thank you.
Could you give me some help here?
Back in! Back in!
Jen, we should expect company.
Could you give me some help here?
Jen, this is a summoning stone, made from the same material as I am. If we get separated, you can use it to pull me back to you.
Okay.
And I literally mean pull. You'll see. Wait there! I'll find some way to get you up!
I'm going to drop a rope down for you. Climb on up.
Okay. Don't let go now.
Help me out, would you? Help me out, would you?
of the Ferai court. How can it have come to this?
If you're looking for the king, I think he has other things on his mind.
Like trying to figure out what you've done with your...
Well, hang on now, Jen. Let's not set off on the wrong foot.
Back in!
Just stand there watching. Help me out here.
Thank you.
Check this out. One of these must be the key we're after.
Excellent. Let's get straight back to Jared.
Agnon? Get out of that!
Do you have the key?
Yes, it was in the Queen's chambers, just as you said.
Thank you.
Permit me to go first, Highness. Who knows what we may find?
My mother is in there. I have nothing to fear.
Sorry, Jared.
Don't be. My friends, I don't need your pity. I need your help. I must destroy this thing that has so defiled my mother.
Of course, we'll do anything.
First, we must unmask the imposter. Do you know any way to break the enchantment?
I don't know. The creature has retained my mother's form, while these remains have stayed free from corruption. There is some dark necromancy at work here. Those chants I heard came from this chamber.
Fire.
What?
The spell must be broken. With your permission, Highness, we should cremate the body.
Let it be done. mother. How did this befall us?
It's done.
What now?
Now, I will have my revenge.
Ah, the hex is broken. But you are too late to save your kingdom.
Not too late to tear your head off.
That too, boy. My final act as Divina was to order her most loyal guards to this chamber, expressly to kill you, their broken prince, along with this feeble mortal and her scuttling stone. Death. Right on time.
No! You've been deceived!
King, and see that this dissembling hag does not move. Jared, alive. My prayers are answered.
I let you down, father. If I had not been captured, none of these terrible...
You've changed, Jared, but I have been nothing but blind. A sovereign fool. Now you must be forever vigilant. Fight with your mind as well as your sword. And know that your mother and I are always with you.
I have much to tell you. We had no choice but to cremate my mother.
Enough! The ritual of succession has been delayed all too long. Now that you are safe, our kingdom can be strong once more. Only one task remains.
Ready to lead, King Jared?
I am ready. My people have much to thank you for. I will not forget you.
Who is that with Belazor?
I was too far away to see clearly. It could have been anyone.
You recognized Belazor, right?
Well, of course I did, but you mortals all look the same to me.
Mortal? What? It was a human?
Not exactly. The reach of chaos is long, and its demons take many forms. It, must have been another of Abaddon's servants. Come on, we must return to the Nexus.
You're holding out on me.
There's no time for this. Abaddon's forces are in motion.
Abaddon, Arella, big deal. None of this has anything to do with me, Scree. I just want to find my boyfriend and go home.
Scree is not your enemy, Jennifer. I sent him to guide and protect you.
You're Arella? Butterflies. That's not what I was expecting.
I am in all things, and I appear in many forms. I understand your frustration, but you must realize that our goals are one and the same.
I doubt that.
It's true. I wish to see you safely return to your home, but...
Why am I being roped into some turf war you're having with Abaddon, then? The way I see it, this is a personal problem. Yours.
Jennifer, if Abaddon gets his way, there will be no more Talis for you to return to. At least not one you would recognize. For eternity, we have existed here in the Nexus. He and I, the one balancing the other so that all can flourish. Without him, there would be no change. No decay. Life in the realms would stagnate. But without my presence, all would descend into the mindless frenzy of chaos. Both sides are needed for harmony. Darkness and light. Chaos and order. A balanced unity. But Abaddon has become obsessed with power. He would see me destroyed. My influence lost, no matter the consequence. What happened in Solum was just the beginning. He will not rest until he has corrupted all the realms, yours included, and become the sole primal force.
This is all making me dizzy. I'm just a coffee shop waitress. Don't you need some kind of superhero helping you out here?
Come now. You have seen the power within yourself. Now unlocked, this will continue to grow. Your part in these events was sealed when you were but a baby. Journey to Aquis, and you will see more of the damage wrought by Abaddon's madness.
Okay. I'll go.
Continue to guide her, loyal Abdazur. She will need your strength when her full self is revealed.
She is a wild creature, but I believe her heart is good.